Latin dancing has exploded in Canada in the past 20 years. It's really changed that, when I first started dancing, basically one style of salsa was taught in Toronto. And oftentimes the style that's taught in a city or in a country is based on the Latin culture, the Latin community in that city. So it's based on immigration, it's based on which countries people have moved to Toronto from. And so at that point, it was one style. And as things evolved and as people started traveling and as Facebook and social media and YouTube came out, people started learning other styles. So now the scene is much more diverse. There's a lot of different styles that are taught, a lot of different styles that are danced. I think congresses play a huge role in the Latin dance community. I think it provides a platform for people, for Canadian dancers to showcase their talent, to be recognized for their hard work. It gives them a chance to be exposed to some of the best choreographers, performers, instructors from around the world. It gives them a chance to network with like-minded people. One of the most important roles that the congresses play is a sense of community. And I think sometimes we forget that, and I think this past year with the pandemic has really brought that home. A lot of people who come to the TD Salsa and Toronto Festival have never seen salsa, have never danced it, have never heard the music. They've never been in that environment or around these cultures. And so I think it really is an amazing experience that people from all walks of life can walk down the street and experience the music and the energy and the vibrancy of the Latin culture and the salsa culture. And so I think it's helped to highlight something that maybe people would never have an opportunity to see otherwise.